The stock on our radar is JK Paper, buzzing in trade on the back of a good set of third quarter earnings, 10% revenue growth, and we have a growth of close to around 72% in the company's net profit, aided by a sharp expansion in their margins. We have Mr. A.S. Mehta of the company joining us to detail those numbers. Thanks a lot, sir, for joining in. Okay, before we do that, some news coming in on Z Media as well. Promoter entities sold 11.1 lakh shares on February 7th via open market. So not particularly good across the Z Group companies, the promoter entities are selling. In fact, that we should also pull up the other group companies like Z Learn as well as Dish TV to see there is some more disclosure coming in.
You know, Mangalam, just going by the price moves on Z Media, now it's more or less flattish. It's still to react to that news. But if you pull up the other one, you know, Z Entertainment as well as Dish TV, all those stocks, they saw a sharp downtick and then they've recovered from the day's low. So I'm wondering whether or not, you know, they have already... inform the mutual funds and inform the lenders that we are going to be doing this sort of move with some promise. I'm just thinking out aloud. The very fact that the stocks have recovered from the low point of the day, was it something that they have already informed the lenders as well as the mutual funds that we're going to do something like this? We're raising liquidity for X reason, whatever it could be. You know, that could be one possibility as well. The other possibility, who's the buyer? So those two points will be quite crucial, because otherwise the stock should have really sold off. But Z Media, Z Entertainment has recovered. Even Dish TV, you know, same promoter group, that one as well has recovered. So we'll just keep an eye out on a couple
of these. Absolutely. This definitely needs a fair amount of monitoring, and that is something that we will be constantly doing. But let's get back to our conversation with Mr. A.S. Mehta, the President and Director of JK Paper. Apologies to keep you waiting, Mr. Mehta. First up, if you could tell us, how exactly were the paper prices during this quarter? How do they compare with the previous quarter as well as the relevant quarter year ago? If you could tell us, that would be, would help us understanding how the price movement was.
Okay. As far as the paper prices in India are concerned, fairly now they are in tandem with the global pulp and paper prices. So since the demand was robust and the global paper prices were on a higher trajectory, so the paper prices were moving upward. And in fact, if you compare the net sales realization during this quarter, it is almost higher by 10% over the previous year, the same quarter. But if you compare with the previous quarter to or the preceding quarter to this quarter, to my mind, the prices were higher just by 1.5% or 2%. So this is on the price scenario.
All right, Mr. Mehta, and what about today? The prices are more or less stable in comparison to quarter three?
I would say that the prices, as far as the copier paper is concerned, they are stable. Only thing is that the coated paper prices have come down globally. So following that trend, the prices of coated paper have come down to the extent of, I would say, 3 to 4%.
Okay.
And our share of coated paper in the total volume is something around 10%.
Okay.
So that won't have a major impact as far as the JK paper is concerned.
Okay, get that point then. Since we're focusing on the top line, you normally tell us you're functioning at full capacity utilization levels. So in the past quarter, what was it? 103, 105, 11%, if you give us some clarity on that front?
In fact, it was something around 108% capacity utilization in that quarter. So we are pretty well on our production parameters, productivity, and the production efficiency level.
Okay.
And as the track record of JK Paper is, I mean, we always try to do better and better.
Absolutely. So better and better. Let's talk about some new capacity being added. Shirpur, what can you talk about that plant? When does that come on stream? And once that does come on stream, how much does your capacity get enhanced by? And what does it mean in terms of revenue?
Okay, it's the Sirpur. We have just started one paper machine and test production had just started last week. So that machine is going to be stabilized in next 10-12 days. Thereafter, we are going to start one more machine, which is a higher capacity machine there. So there also, it will be test production in the month of March. So I would say that the both these machines should be up and running from 1st of April. By that time, we should also have the pulp mill there ready. So we will start pulp production and also the paper from the two machines from 1st of April. Once we start this, See, the whole capacity of this plant is going to be 1,40,000 odd ton from the four machines. In fact, we will be shutting four smaller machines, and after revamping, refurbishing and renovating or modernizing the four machines, we will have a full capacity of 1,40,000 ton. So that will be addition to the existing capacity of 4.5 lakh ton of JK paper.
Okay. So let's get to the point then, right, Mr. Mehta? In FY20, what kind of numbers can you deliver? If you're going to be a 1.4 lakh ton capacity is what you're going to have. In FY20, how do you scale up? Do you do less than 50% capacity utilization, more than 50% capacity utilization? And if you would give us a ballpark, you know, going by current paper prices, what sort of revenue should you be getting out of this unit, this input unit?
See, I would say that JK Paper is selling something around close to or higher by almost 5 lakh ton of production from our own facility. And we source 50,000 ton of paper. At the same time, my estimate is that we should be producing something around 90,000 to a lakh ton from Sirpur paper mill. So in all, it would be somewhere around 6 lakh to 6 lakh 50,000 ton of total the volume.
Okay.
And going forward, the current prices, to my mind, the net sales, we should be somewhere around upward from 3,500 crore.
All right, upward by 3,500 crore. Mr. Mehta, you know, there are news reports which suggest that there is a global company, an Indonesian company, setting a paper plant in Karnataka. Any word on that? What exactly is going to happen once that company comes? And will that impact prices?
See, the announcement is by the Asia Pulp and Paper to set up their plant in Andhra Pradesh, not in Karnataka. When it happens, when does it happen? That's one question. If it happens in 2 years' time, 3 years' time, 5 years' time, I mean, it's not clearly understood in the market.
Okay.
So, I mean, what kind of a product mix also they come up, that is also not known. So, it's very difficult at this point.
All right, Mr. Mehta, you know, I wanted to ask you about one particular factor very quickly. You know, in the past, you have been talking about scaling up your plantation. I believe it was around 5,000 hectares in the past. And then you have scaled it up to around 15,000 hectares. How does this help in terms of, you know, your captive requirement? And when does this come in? Because I think you can't chop for maybe around 4 to 5 years, right?
In fact, you're right. In the basic differentiator today and the most competitive advantage to JK Paper today is the plantation. Because what I said is that 5 years back, we used to do plantation of close to 4,000 hectare. But from last almost 5 years now, the plantation on an average, it is more than 12,000 hectare. So in fact, that is mature now. I mean, we are getting close to 80% of our wood from the nearby area, and that is the reason that the raw material cost has substantially come down for JK Paper. And in time to come, this is going to be a foremost focus area for JK Paper, and that will give a sustainable advantage on the lower raw material cost to us.
Okay. All right. Thanks a lot, Mr. Mehta, for stopping by and giving us all those details. So, very optimistic sounding, Mr. Mehta of JK Paper. The stock higher by about 2-2.5%. Good results, a strong top line growth as well as strong bottom line growth. With